The Wemmicks were small wooden people. All of the wooden people were carved by a woodworker named Eli. His workshop sat on a hill overlooking their village. Each Wemmick was different. Some had big noses, others had large eyes, and some were tall and others were short. Some wore hats, others wore coats. But all were made by the same carver, and all lived in the village. All day, every day, the Wemmicks did the same thing. They gave each other stickers. Each Wemmick had a box of golden star stickers and a box of grey dot stickers. Up and down the street, all over the city, people spent their day sticking stars or dots on one another. The pretty ones, those with smooth wood and fine paint, always got stars. But if the wood was rough or the paint chipped, the Wemmicks gave dots. The talented ones got stars too. Some could lift big sticks high above their heads or jump over tall boxes. Still others knew big words or could sing pretty songs. Everyone gave them stars. Some Wemmicks had stars all over them. Every time they got a star, it made them feel so good. It made them want to do something else and get another star. Others, though, could do little. They got dots. Punchinello was one of these. He tried to jump high like the others, but he always fell. And when he fell, the others would gather around him and give him dots. Sometimes when he fell, his wood got scratched, so the people would give him more dots. Then, when he would try to explain why he fell, he would say something silly, and the Wemmicks would give him more dots. After a while, he had so many dots that he didn't want to go outside. He was afraid he would do something dumb, such as forget his hat or step in the water, and then people would give him another dot. In fact, he had so many grey dots that people would come up to him and give him dots for no reason at all.
"He deserves lots of dots," the people would agree with one another. "He's not a good person."
After a while, Punchinello believed them.
"I'm not a good Wemmick," he would say.
The few times he went outside, he hung around with other Wemmicks who had lots of dots. He felt better around them. One day, he met a Wemmick who was unlike any he'd ever met. She had no dots or stars. She was just wooden, and her name was Lucia. It wasn't that people didn't try to give her stickers, it's just that the stickers didn't stick. Some of the Wemmicks admired Lucia for having no dots, so they would run up to her and give her a star, but it would fall off. Others would look down on her for having no stars, so they would give her a dot, but it wouldn't stay either. "That's the way I want to be," thought Punchinello. "I don't want anyone's marks." So he asked the stickerless Wemmick how she did it.
"It's easy," Lucia replied. "Every day I go and see Eli." "Eli?"
"Yes, Eli, the woodcarver. I sit in the workshop with him."
"Why?"
"Why don't you find out yourself? Go up the hill. He's there." And with that, the Wemmick who had no stickers turned and skipped away.
"But will he want to see me?"
Punchinello cried out. Lucia didn't hear. So Punchinello went home. He sat near a window and watched the wooden people as they scurried around, giving each other stars and dots.
"It's not right,"
he muttered to himself. And he decided to go and see Eli. He walked up the narrow path to the top of the hill and stepped into the big shop. His wooden eyes widened at the size of everything. The stool was as tall as he was. He had to stretch on tiptoes to see the top of the workbench. A hammer was as long as his arm. Punchinello swallowed hard.
"I'm not staying here."
And he turned to leave. And then he heard his name.
"Punchinello?"
The voice was deep and strong. Punchinello stopped.
"Punchinello, how good to see you. Come, and let me have a look at you."
Punchinello turned slowly and looked at the large bearded craftsman.
"You know my name?"
the little Wemmick asked.
"Of course I do. I made you."
Eli stooped down and picked him up and sat him on the bench. The maker spoke thoughtfully as he looked at the grey dots.
"Looks like you have been given some bad marks."
"I didn't mean to, Eli. I really tried hard."
"Oh, you don't have to defend yourself to me, child. I don't care what the other Wemmicks think."
"You don't?"
"No, and you shouldn't either. Who are they to give stars or dots? They're Wemmicks, just like you. What they think doesn't matter. All that matters is what I think. And I think you are pretty special."
Punchinello laughed.
"Me? Special? Why? I can't walk fast. I can't jump. My paint is peeling. What do I matter to you?"
Eli looked at Punchinello, put his hands on those small wooden shoulders, and spoke very slowly.
"Because you're mine. That's why you matter to me."
Punchinello had never had anyone look at him like this, much less his maker. He didn't know what to say.
"Every day I've been hoping you'd come," Eli explained.
"I came because I met someone who had no marks," said Punchinello.
"I know. She told me about you."
"Why don't the stickers stay on her?"
The maker spoke softly.
"Because she has decided that what I think is more important than what they think. The stickers only stick if you let them."
"What?"
"The stickers only stick if they matter to you. The more you trust my love, the less you care about their stickers."
"I'm not sure I understand."
Eli smiled.
"You will, but it will take time. You've got a lot of marks. For now, just come to see me every day, and let me remind you how much I care."
Eli lifted Punchinello off the bench and set him on the ground.
"Remember,"
Eli said as the Wemmick walked out of the door,
"you are special because I made you, and I don't make mistakes."
Punchinello didn't stop, but in his heart he thought, "I think he really means it." And when he did, a dot fell to the ground.